piecewise defined function consisting of three segments and ask to graph the inverse. What we will be doing is noting the endpoints of the segments and interchanging the x and y coordinates of each of those endpoints when we draw new segments, and that will reflect the graph over the line y equals x. So notice that the original endpoints are at negative 10, negative 8, negative 4, negative 4, 9, negative 2, and 10, 8. And so when we draw the graph using the graphing tool, first of all, we will choose the segment tool. We'll move our first endpoint that was at negative 10, negative 8 to negative 8, negative 10. So negative 8, negative 10. The second point was negative 4, negative 4. And since it is on the line y equals x, it will still be on the inverse. Now we select the segment tool again, select negative 4, negative 4 again, and this time go to negative 2, 9, since 9, negative 2 was on the original. Go back one more time and select negative 2, 9, and then we'll be selecting 8, 10, since the original went through 10, 8. And notice by default, each of these endpoints has been graphed with a closed circle, and we were told to use closed endpoints here. So let's go to the next one. Here we have another piecewise defined function. However, there's only two segments this time, and our endpoints are negative 10, negative 9, negative 3, 7, and 10, 10. So we will be wanting our endpoints on the inverse to be negative 9, 10, 7, negative 3, and 10, 10. Going to the graphing tool, I select the segment and find negative 9, negative 10. Click on that. Then 7, negative 3. Go back and pick the segment tool again. Go back and select 7, negative 3. And finally, go up to 10, 10. Note 10, 10 is in both the original and the inverse function.